Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use Two-Points Constraint and Transformation Limit nodes, which are a series of nodes that can be used to subject parts of a cutout character rig to certain physical constraints. So let's start. You'll need a simple character design that follows the rigging stages seen in my tutorials on character breakdown and advanced auto patch and pegs. To practice and understand Two-Points Constraints, we'll start with an exercise using simple geometric shapes that represent a limb, such as the leg or arm. And after, I'll demonstrate how you can apply this technique to a character rig. Using the preset rectangle tool, set the pencil size and preset texture. Make a rectangle shape. Name the drawing upper leg. Make a new drawing, name it lower leg. Copy the rectangle from the previous drawing and paste it into the lower leg drawing. Leave a gap between them so we can add the knee joint. Make a new drawing, name it knee. Use the preset ellipse tool. Hold shift to constrain proportions. Make the circle diameter match the width of the rectangle and place it centrally between the two rectangles. We have three drawings. Let's add multiple pegs. Add the rotation points using the rotate tool. The position of the rotation points are very important for this technique. Start with the upper leg, put the rotation point at the top. The knee rotation point is centered. The lower leg rotation point is not what you expect. Place it at the bottom. When you test this rig, you'll know if you've got this right. Now let's get the Two-Points Constraint. Hit Enter for the node library and put in the first two letters. A two-point constraint constrains a drawing between the pivot point of two pegs. This node can be configured to squash and stretch the drawing it transforms automatically, as well as to stop stretching or squashing the drawing past specified limits. This can be especially useful for rigging limbs together and allow the animator to manipulate them by their articulations. The Two-Points Constraint is attached to the part that you want to constrain or lock. In this example, we can start with the upper leg. We attach it between the peg and drawing node. The peg should be attached on either the left or right ports, not the switch port, which is indicated with a different color. Let's repeat for the lower leg piece, which we also want locked by its articulation. Go to the knee peg, take a connector from under the knee peg, connect to the two-point constraint right port attached to the upper leg. Repeat and attach it to the left port of the lower leg. Now let's test it. Select the knee peg, select transform, and move the knee where you see the crosshair indicator, not on the rotation point. You'll see the knee that is constrained to its adjacent parts will move those other body parts along with it. You'll note that the upper and lower leg shapes have distorted and become very stretchy. To adjust the limits of that squash and stretch, let's open up the properties of the Two-Points Constraint. Or you can open up the Layer Properties panel if you prefer. The active value is the percentage of influence the constraint has on its child element. 100 will follow closely, and at 0, the piece will not be affected by the constraint. Volume modifier defines how much the two-point constraints node should preserve the width of the child element when the distance between the points causes it to stretch or squash. If set to 100, the width of the element will increase when squashed and decreased when stretched, based on the volume max and volume min parameters. If set to 0, the element will always have the same width regardless of how much it is stretched or squashed. Volume max, the maximum width of the element when squashed. Volume min, the minimum width of the element when stretched. It can feel overwhelming with the numeric values, so let's set all these values at 100 and you can play around with those values. You can see and feel the stretchiness as we move the articulation. Set the same values at the 2-point constraint attached to the lower leg. For purposes of keeping the character on model, you can add a transformation limit. The transformation limit node can be used as another constraint between two nodes to limit the effect of the parent peg's transformations onto the child. Get a transformation limit from the node library, attach it above the 2-point constraint. It must be connected to the peg or element it will apply the transformation to via its output port. Attach the upper leg peg to the right input port so that the transformations are processed by the transformation limit node by its immediate parent. Open up the layer properties so we see the values in the transformation limit node. Try changing the translate x value to 50, and you will see the piece is constrained and has a limited range of movement. Test translate y values and change that to 50. You can play around with those values. Let's add a transformation limit to the lower leg, copy the xy values from the knee peg. We can add a master peg to connect the upper and lower pegs. And that will move those pieces constraining the knee compared to the other way. If you connect the knee peg, you can move all the child pegs together, but you will need to disable the transformation limit. And that's it for the 2-point constraint exercise. Finally, I'll demonstrate how to apply the 2-point constraint to my rig Cholula, and you can watch to see how it might work on your character design. I'll show you the leg. It's helpful to use backdrops to highlight the articulation points, such as the ankle, knee, and hip. Get a 2-point constraint. Attach it above the lower leg peg. Attach the ankle and knee pegs, making sure they have rotation points in. Add a 2-point constraint above the upper leg. Attach the knee and hip pegs, making sure they have their rotation points in. To complete the peg hierarchy, you can add a peg that connects the knee to its child, the ankle. Add a master leg peg at the top of the hierarchy that connects the lower leg pieces. Add the rotation point by copying and pasting the values from the corresponding pegs. Let's test it. And that's it for 2-point constraints and the transformation limit. In the next tutorial, we will cover deformers for this rig. Check out my tutorials for character breakdown, auto patch, and deformers. Thanks for watching. See you next time.